Hello friends, I am Bhaskar Arun, and in this talk I will introduce you to our universe. One of the fascinating things about the universe is that it is vast beyond our imagination. Just to give an idea, the size of solar system is roughly 10 light minutes. The size of a typical galaxy is roughly 100,000 light years, which means in order for light to travel from one side to the other side, it will take 100,000 years. And in order to map the distribution of galaxies in the universe, there have been several sky surveys. One such survey is the SDSS, which looks as far as 2 billion light years. And if you look at the map where every point is a galaxy, that gives you an idea of the size of the universe. And the study of the origin and evolution of the universe is called cosmology. Now we will move on to some technical stuff. Here I will discuss some equations and theories that form the backbone of studying cosmology. First is the Hubble-Lemaître law. In the late 1920s, Lemaître theoretically derived an expression between recession velocity and distance of a point in space, which happens to be a linear relation for small distances. You can see it here. This was observationally proved by Edwin Hubble, who measured recession velocity and distance of galaxies in the space. So every point here is a galaxy, and he fitted a straight line. His values of recession velocities were not accurate, but the general idea stayed true. Hence, it is established that the universe is expanding. The expanding model of the universe was derived by Friedman and Lemaître independently by solving the equations of general relativity. The equations are quite complex and I will not be discussing them here, but the model implies that if the universe is expanding, then at some point in the past it must have been denser and hotter and it was radiation dominated. And both these conclusions have been verified by BBN and CMB. So BBN, or Big Bang Nucleosynthesis, is the production of light elements in early universe, and CMB is a faint microwave signal that we can detect from all directions. The figure here shows the eventual fate of the universe depending upon its matter density. If the matter density of the universe is greater than some critical density, then the universe would stop expanding at some point and start contracting. But our universe happens to be an escalating universe because of the presence of dark energy, which I will explain later. Okay. Now, one of the most fundamental questions about the universe is that what it is made of. So there are primarily three constituents of the universe. First is the radiation, or relativistic matter, which basically is your light and which at all wavelengths, let's say optical, gamma, radio, everything. The second is the non-relativistic matter, which again has three types mostly. First is the neutrinos. So neutrinos are particles that were relativistic at early times, but not anymore. Second is the baryons, which includes your protons, neutrons, and electrons, basically all the matter that you can see. And third is the dark matter. It's a type of matter that does not interact with light. It was theorized to explain various astrophysical observations, such as the galaxy rotation curve, where you see that the galaxies are rotating much faster than you expect them to be. And the third component is the dark energy. It's a negative pressure substance which uniformly fills all the space. It was again hypothesized to explain the escalating nature of the universe. So which means that the universe is not only expanding, its expansion rate is getting faster with time. And the figure shows the energy budget of the universe. You can see that the matter that you can see is only 5%, while rest 95% is dark energy and dark matter, something which we truly do not understand yet. And finally, I would like to just summarize the evolution of the universe. So after the Big Bang, The universe was a hot, dense, ionized plasma. And as it expanded, it got cooler and cooler. And roughly 400,000 years later, it was cold enough to form atoms and molecules. These atoms and molecules continued to form bigger structures. But since there were no stars and galaxies at this point, it is often called the Dark Age. And this Dark Age lasted nearly 100 million years until the first stars and galaxies came into existence. These stars and galaxies ionized the universe again, hence it is called the reionization era, which lasted up till a billion years, roughly speaking. And since then, various astrophysical processes have been going on, which have resulted in several stars and galaxies and other objects that we see today. So that would be all from my side. Thank you for listening patiently. If there are any questions, please feel free to ask them. Thank you.